Shao Yong. Shao Yong, Chinese, pinyin, Shao Yong, Wade Giles, Shao Yong, 1011-1077, courtesy name Yaofu, named Shao Kāngjié, was a Chinese philosopher, cosmologist, poet and historian who greatly influenced the development of Neo-Confucianism in China during the Song Dynasty. Shao is considered one of the most learned men of his time. Unlike most men of such stature in his society, Shao avoided governmental positions his entire life, but his influence was no less substantial. He wrote an influential treatise on cosmogony, the Huangji Jingxi, Book of Supreme World Ordering Principles. Origins. Shao's ancestors were from Fanyang. He was born in 1011 in an area known as Hangjiang County, now Anyang, Henan, to Shao Gu, 986-1064, and Lady Li, d. 1032 or 1033. Shao's mother, Li, was an extremely devout practitioner of Buddhism. This link with Buddhism proved to be a major influence on Shao's thought throughout his life. Shao Yong's first teacher was Shao Gu, his father. This was common practice in the familial environment of China at the time. Shao Gu was a scholar in philology and his influence can be discerned in Shao's literary works. Guided by his father, he studied the six Confucian classics intensively at a young age. Shao also sought out the scholarship of private schools, many of which were run by monks and heavily influenced by Buddhism. Around 1020, the Shao family moved to Gongcheng County, now Xinjiang, Henan. Shortly after his mother's death in 1032 or 1033, Shao met his most important teacher, Li Dikai. Li was a former pupil of ancient prose specialist Mu Shu, 979-1032. Under Mu Shu, Li had studied the I Ching extensively. Career in later life. Shao was a member of a group of thinkers who gathered in the Luoyang toward the last three decades of the 11th century. This group had two primary objectives. One of these was to draw parallels between their own streams of thought and that of Confucianism as understood by Mencius. Secondly, the men set out to undermine any links, real or otherwise, between 4th century Confucianism and what they viewed as inferior philosophical schools of thinking, namely Buddhism and Taoism. Other loosely connected members of this so-called network of thinkers include Cheng Yi, Zhang Zai, Cheng Hao, 1032-1085, and Zhou Dunyi. Central to each of these men was the ancient text I Ching, which each had studied closely. The way in which Shao studied this ancient text, however, differed from the other members. During the Song Dynasty, there were two main approaches in I Ching studies. Together with the majority of scholars, the other members of the group took the Yili Shui, principle study, approach, which was based on literalistic and moralistic concepts. The other approach, taken by Shao alone, was the Shangshu Shui, image number study, approach, which was based much more on iconographic and cosmological concepts. An approach to I Ching divination known as Mei Huayi has been attributed to him. Xu Maquang, a close friend of Shao Yong, edited the Take Xuanjing by Yang Xuang, written in 1080. Influenced by the base three-number system found in the Take Xuanjing, probably drawing on this association and the realization of a base three system employed in the Take Xuanjing, Shao Yong then set the hexagrams of the I Ching into a binary sequence, the Fuzai ordering. This in turn influenced Leibniz and his thinking on binary arithmetic, and in turn the language of modern computers. Descendants. Shao Yong's offspring held the title of Wu Jingboshi, Wu Jingboshi. In 1452, Wu Jingboshi was bestowed upon the offspring of Meng Zi Mengxu in 56th generation and Yan Hewei Yan Shui 59th generation. The same was bestowed on the offspring of Zhou Dunyi Zhou Mian 12th generation, the two Cheng brothers, Cheng Hao and Cheng Yi Chen Karen 17th generation, Zhu Zai Zhu Ting, Zhu Chan, 9th generation, in 1456-1457. In 1539 the same was awarded to Zeng Kan's offspring Zeng Dika 60th generation, in 1622 the offspring of Zhang Zai received the title and in 1630 the offspring of Shao Yong. Poetry. Shao is also famous for his poetry and for his interest in the game of Go, Weizi. He wrote a great ode to watching Weizi, one of the longest surviving classical Chinese poems, as well as a long ode to watching Weizi, which is translated below.